गुड मॉर्निंग टू वन एंड ऑल। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट दिस डी वाटरिंग टेक्निक्स। मीन्स डी वाटरिंग टेक्निक्स आर ए पार्ट ऑफ ग्राउंड इम्प्रूवमेंट टेक्निक्स। फर्दर टू दिस डी वाटरिंग टेक्निक्स आर किप्ट इन आवर सिलेबस एज ए सेकेंड चैप्टर। इन द टोटल डी वाटरिंग टेक्निक्स वी आर हैविंग डिफरेंट फिलासफीज, बट इन टूडेज क्लास वी हैव टू डिस्कस अबाउट वॉट इज डी वाटरिंग, where it was located, what is the purpose of removing all the water content in the soil itself, and what are the consequences we need to face whenever a structure having a quantity of this water amount in the particular soil layers. What are the consequences we need to face, and why we have to design these dewatering techniques. What are the different philosophies involved and different design philosophies involved, and how we need to control this groundwater percolation into our surrounding soils. Is there any remedial measures or anything? All those things are discussed in these classes. First of all, we have to know about this dewatering method. What is a dewatering? How we have to go for this dewatering? First of all, before going to know about this dewatering, that means dewatering, that means we have to remove a proper quantity of this water from the surface or any below the ground surface. If the total quantity of water is much more than the normal water level in the surrounding soils, definitely we have to remove the total water from our soil. All those are comes under normal removal of the water. But in case of this definition, we have to know about what is water table. Normally, this water table is a term we are listening whenever we need to have to go for this boring systems. That means normally in the villages and other small scale cities, those who are dependent upon these agricultural systems, and they are having a lot of scarcity of water in the surrounding fields. So definitely they will go for this bore wells and others. Why? Because there is no rivers or any other water bodies in the surrounding strata, so that they have to depend upon these groundwater levels, and then they need to remove the water from below the ground level, so that this water table is much more hearing at that particular strata. First of all, we need to know about this water table. What is water table? That means the water is above the table or below the table. That means you need to know. Most of the people know that water table has something to do with groundwater. Means the term groundwater here, that means that whatever the water lies below the ground surface, all those called as a groundwater. Whatever the water above the ground level, that is a perennial water. That means in the form of rivers or any other canals, we have to see those kind of water. But in case of this groundwater, means we can't see this flow of groundwater. Why? Because the total soil is as an obstruction to see this groundwater. So that we have some amount of this electrical and other techniques to find out the amount of groundwater from the particular ground level. The old table provides an image of flat surface like a table top, and the commonly assumed that when a well is drilled, it strikes water once it reaches to the below the water table. It means the whole table provides an image of flat surface, the total world as a globe having a flat surface like a table top. That means whenever the we have a table, so that the total soil we have to fill it as a total table. After that, it is a commonly assumed that the well is drilled. That means from the table itself, we need to drill a well point to remove the quantity of water which will lies below the ground layer, so that those water is available below the ground layer, so that all those water we will call it as a groundwater. The amount of depth from the particular ground surface it is available, so that it is called as a water table. Water table normally measured in terms of meters or any other feet. Why? Because it is a length. It means the total length from ground surface it was available in terms of meters or feet in major locations. After that, groundwater is a subsurface water. That means surface water and subsurface water. Surface water normally we are observing in the forms of rivers, ponds and streams, and most of the surface water is in the form of seas, that means samudralu, but not all the subsurface water is groundwater. Manaki anni chotla unnatundi subsurface water motham kuda groundwater kaadu. In few countries like Arab countries, we are having petroleum as a ground level, that means below the ground level they are having this petroleum as a major source for their countries. That means those petroleum are useful for their countries to produce a huge quantity of money by exporting those petroleums and other natural resources. But in case of our countries, we are having a plenty amount of this natural gas, and this water lies below the ground level. So that this natural gas is nowadays we are observing in our KG Basin and the surroundings of this Godavari Delta areas, we are having a large quantity of this natural gas. In our future purpose, it will be useful for us for our daily needs. After that, we are having a plenty amount of this ground level water. That means ground level water means below the ground level we are having this ground water. So that simply we are removing and removing and removing this ground water. Why? Because for our agricultural purpose. In our Andhra Pradesh itself, we are having a small scale of water which will be available in different cities like our Guntur and Krishna. We are having majorly this Krishna River, and after that East Godavari, West Godavari, they are having Godavari River. Those two are some amount of perennial rivers they have, such that they are having a particular amount of water in their year. That means in the year means if there is a 12 months, minimum of 8 to 9 months they are having a particular quantity of water. Mostly that means if there is a 100 years, in this particular 100 years span, there are having a much quantity of water compared to other districts. But in case of our Prakasam district, Nellur and Srikakulam and Vijayanagaram, those are having some less quantity of rivers. So that all those countries are majorly depends upon these groundwater resources for their fertilization. That means fertilization means farming purpose. So that upper surface of the groundwater is the water table, and below the surface the pore spaces and cracks in the sediments of the rocks are completely filled with this water. That means whenever the water is flowing from the particular surface of a ground level, due to these gravitational forces, that means due to this gravity means automatically the center part of the earth having some amount of power of absorption. So that due to those charge, the total quantity of water will be flowing on the water surface will have a certain quantity of percolation due to this availability of pores and other cracks in the subsurfaces. And below the subsurfaces, we are having a huge quantity of cracks and voids. Those voids we are called it as a pores. So that due to those voids and pores or cracks, whatever there lies below the structure, all those will have a capability of absorbing this groundwater which were flowing on the top surface due to these gravitational forces. So that the total quantity of water which was absorbed by this gravitational force will be flow along the slope of a particular layers, and they will be stored in the form of groundwater. So that that groundwater we will use for different purposes like agricultural purposes. In some of the countries or some of the cities, we are used for industrial purpose also. That means if there is a industry, so that the industry will have to use certain quantity of water in their daily needs. And for a few apartments also, we are having these bore wells for their daily purpose of drinking and sanitary purposes. Likely this groundwater table will be useful for those for choosing their daily needs. So that we are having some amount of saturated zones and unsaturated zones. Saturated means that full voids are completely filled with this water. Those are called as a saturated zones. And if the none is saturated, automatically theoretical zone where groundwater occurs, strictly speaking, only found the saturated zone of groundwater only. All those terms are related to only groundwater table. What is water table location? That means how we need to measure this availability of groundwater in a particular field. Those are different techniques already we seen in engineering geology. That means engineering geology is totally related to the ground surface and below the ground surface what we are having in the form of minerals or any other liquid substance or solid substance. What are the stratas and folds, faults, unconformities, strikes and dips and different mineral properties. All those terms we are discussed in engineering geology. Those knowledge will be useful for few quantity in this ground improvement techniques for finding these groundwater tables and other folds and faults. Why? Because this ground is also associated with this engineering geology. First of all, to calculate or to count the particular groundwater level from a surface, we need to use this Hoare-Slaves method. In this Hoare-Slaves method, how we have to find the groundwater table means, first of all, we need to take this borehole observation in the simplest technique, means whatever the simplest way to calculate the borehole data, we have to calculate that boreholes are drilled during a surface and investigation can be kept open for 24 hours. That means a particular length of borehole will be drilled from the ground level itself. At a particular length means if it is a 2 meters or 3 meters, normally they will drill a particular borehole and they will kept for and observe for a 24 hours span. That means they will simply for a one day they will drill a particular quantity of length of the bore. After that they will observe for 24 hours. That means if there is a void means automatically water flows along the slope, so that if there is a chance of finding water at that particular depth after the 24 hours, if there is no water means automatically they will drive for another quantity of length. Likely they are simply observing at a particular depth, simply they will find the water. It may be 100 feet or 150 feet or 200 feet depending upon the percolation capacities of the particular water. That means if the soil is simply porosity having huge amount of voids, means automatically there will be much more amount of water will be available at a normal depths. If the soil is normally hard rock strata, there will be a huge amount of length we need to go. Why? Because hard rock strata means automatically there will be no percolation for the water, so that we need to drill a huge amount of lengths of the boreholes. The soil is simply voids means automatically those voids will be absorbed huge amount of rain water in the rainy season, so that we need to find it at a very small depths. This level of water is normally determined by lowering the tap with a float of a by electrical switching device which is equated or contacted with the water. That means normally a level of water is normally determined by lowering the tap with a float or by a electrical switching device. That means these electrical switching devices have a capability of finding these waves which was coming through this water. If there is a flow of water means automatically there may be some amount of sound or any other will be formed, so that those will be located and understanding by these electrical and electronic equipments, so that they have to use these electronic switching devices for normally finding of this water table after drilling a borehole. It is a cohesive soil stratum. The stabilization of water table may take time. That means cohesive means automatically the water table will have to find by time. That means it is a time dependent. Automatically time increases, we have to find the borehole data. In such situations, the location may be ascertained by adopting extrapolation method. That means some amount of extrapolation method. What is this extrapolation method? We have to observe. In such situations, that means if the time increases and there is no water quantity for a particular depth, automatically we will go for this exploitation techniques. In this case, a plot of water table at various time is made and the groundwater level is estimated by exploiting the curve until that becomes parallel to the time axis. In several levels noticed at of equal time intervals, the flowing computational method is used. That means simply we have to observe for a such small quantity of time after the drilling the hole. If there is no water flow or by using these electronic equipments, automatically we have to go for another quantity of length. After that also we won't have a flowing of water, means we need to go for another quantity of length. Likely we have to drive the particular borehole until we will get the water by using these electrostatic equipments. This is the method about horse race method. After that rising wall method by horse race, this is another kind of method to find this groundwater method. This method is also referred as a time lag method or computational method. Time lag means simply time is consuming. Lagging means simply the extra time we need to spend for this method or computational method. It consists of a bailing the water out by casing and then observing the rate of rise of water level in the casing at intervals of the time until the rise in water level becomes negligible. Negligible, it consists of a bailing the water out at a casing. That means casing means normally these casings are provided in a boreholes. Why? Because we are continuously digging the surface, automatically there may be some quantity of mud will be fell onto the hole, so that there may be chance of మనకి యొక్క హోల్ మొత్తం కూడా ఆటోమేటిక్గా మనం వాటర్ అనేది ప్రివెంట్ చేస్తూ ఉన్నప్పుడు సమ్ క్వాంటిటీ ఆఫ్ మడ్ విల్ బి పోర్డ్ ఇన్ టు ద పర్టికులర్ స్ట్రేటా అండ్ ద టోటల్ హోల్ విల్ బి బ్లాక్డ్ బై దిస్ మడ్ పార్టికల్ సో దట్ వీఆర్ యూజింగ్ దిస్ ప్లాస్టింగ్ కేజింగ్స్ టు అబ్స్ట్రక్ట్ దోస్ ఫాలింగ్ ఆఫ్ మడ్ పార్టికల్స్ ఆన్ టు ద వాటర్ సో దట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ వెరీ యూస్ఫుల్ ఫర్ అస్ ఫర్ ద రేట్ ఆఫ్ అబ్జర్వ్డ్ ద మెజరింగ్ ఆఫ్ ఎవలాప్స్ టైమ్ అండ్ డెప్త్ ఆఫ్ వాటర్ సర్ఫేస్ బిలో ద టాప్ ఆఫ్ ద కేసింగ్ దట్ మీన్స్ simply by driving, after driving the particular quantity of data, we have to use some quantity of time elapsing, so that this time elapsing will give the data of flowing of water or any, that means if there is any flow of water, means automatically due to this time elapsing method we will find out the flowing water or any other it interval the intervals at the readings are required will where is somewhat the permeability of the soil. That means permeability of the soil means automatically there may be some quantity of seepage. Automatically it will tells us what is the permeability of the soil in our geotechnical engineering. That means GTE labs we are having these permeability tests for water. How much amount of water will be permeable to the particular soil? What is the maximum water permeability capacity? Those will be helpful as for to find out the particular soil strata and permeability capacities. If no case should be elapsed time, the readings will be less than 5 minutes. That means for each and every 5 minutes after digging a particular borehole data, we have to use this method of finding water. In freely draining materials such as sands, gravels, etc., the interval time between successive readings may be not exceeds 1 to 2 hours. That means if there is a draining materials such as sands, gravels, etc., the interval time between successive readings may be not exceeds 1 to 2 hours. For normal permeable soils, we have to take a time for 5 minutes. But in case of these sands and gravels, why? Because of these sands and gravel means normally a hard substrate. Sand is also normally a substance which is having huge quantity of void, so that all the water can be stored in a particular space, particular place only. There will be no movement of water due to this bulking capacity and other normally we are observed in sand, so that there may be some flow of water, so that we need to wait for a huge span, nearly 1 to 2 hours. But in soils of low permeability such as fine sand and silts and clays, the interval may be varies from 12 to 24 hours. Whatever we discuss means we have to wait for a 1 or 2 day. That means after the digging a particular length of hole, we need to wait for a normal time period. It depends upon the type of soil. Here also they mentioned that after digging a hole and we need to observe the field surface. What kind of surface it is? It is a sandy surface or fine grain or silt or clay or black garden soil. Likely we are having different kinds of soils, so that for each and every kind of soil we are having a separate permeability tests, separate permeability properties, so that
by using those permeability properties, we need to wait for a time period. If it is a sandy soils or gravel soils, normally we have to wait for 1 to 2 hours. For suppose it is a fine grained or silt or any other clay means, automatically we have to wait for a time of 12 to 24 hours, and it may take a few days to determine the stabilized water level. That means stabilized water level means normally in few of the places we are having at a different portions, we are having some quantity of water. That means some quantity means it may be varies from 100 liters to 200 liters depending upon the this void and different breakages in the earth level. Totally we are digging and we are simply removing all the water, automatically there may be no water, so that we have to find a proper groundwater level so that it will give a continuous water, not a breaking of groundwater. That means breaking of water. This is the hover space method for finding a groundwater table. Normally in the top top we are using this casing. Why? Because due to lack of casing, the total material will be falling into the this borehole, and that will helps, that will decreases the length of the borehole. That means length means normally in the form of depth of the door hole, not in terms of width. Total width may be not changing, the depth of the borehole changes, and automatically groundwater level will be decreases. So that we need to use these casings. Here we are having different heights, H1, H2, H3. Those are in small, in the terms of small letters. Normally we are having, after that we are having capital H0, H1, H2, H3. So that H3 plus, here we are having stabilized groundwater level after that. And H1 is not equal to H2, is not equal to H3. After that we are having that difference means here we are having some amount of difference with respect to length, so that they are simply mentioning H1 is not equal to H2, H2 is not equal to H3. Like we are having delta T1 is equal to delta T2 equal to delta T3. That means delta T means time we are waiting. Delta T1, delta T2, delta T3. That means 0 day, first day, second day, third day, likely we have to wait for the quantity of water available on a particular surface level. So that it is a perennial quantity or imperennial quantity. That means the total water is available is a perennial or not. Normal ga manaki konni konni areas lo water vesinappudu konni streets lone manaku water available ga untundi. After few days the total water will be sinks. Why? Total water will be overs. Why? Because there may be some quantity of water available in the top layers only, so that whenever we are driving all those water, after that there may be no water. So that we have to go for a better method for understanding this huge quantity of water. Here we are having this discussion about this hover space method. Let the time be T0 when the water table level was at a depth of H0 below the normal water table. Let the successive rise in the levels H1, H2, H3, etc. and times T1, T2, T3, etc. Okay, these are the different times. After that, we have to flow calculate this difference of time levels. T1 minus T0, T2 minus T1 and T3 minus T2. Actually, it is kept as a constant. After that, we have to get this H1, H2, H3 equal to H0. That means H0 is the overall depth. Overall depth minus H1, they will get this small H1. After that, H1 minus H2 will get, they will get small H2. H2 minus H3, he will get small H3. Likely, there may be a equation between capital H and small H. That means overall height and normal height in the particular diagram. And similarly, they are having a time difference also. T1 minus T0 equal to T2 minus T1 equal to T3 minus T3. So that there may be some equilibrium time. That means delta T means all the time period should be equal to delta T. That means time between two successive values. H0 equal to H1 square by H1 minus H2. Simply they are having these equations of driving height. That means at what height we need to drive on first case, in second case how much amount of height we need to drive, in third case how much amount of height we need to drive for a particular borehole. Normally drive means we need to remove a particular quantity of length of material or area of material. Here we are having HW1 equal to HW minus H0. HW minus H0 equal to, we are having H1 plus H2 minus H2. Likely different terminal, all those are we are having not useful. Only we are discussing all those topics for our awareness purpose. That means in the ground improvement techniques, mainly we have to focus on what is the groundwater level for a particular soil, how we need to find it, what is the purpose of finding this groundwater. Means we are constructing a large structures. Suppose for those large structure we have to dig a foundation at a proper levels. That means whatever the hard rock strata we have, up to the hard rock strata we need to drive a particular quantity of material, and after the driving is over, that means driving of material is over, we need to lay down the foundation. In the hard rock strata itself we are having a huge quantity of that means if you are digging the total surface, means automatically the present, in the presence of water, the digging process will be takes a huge time. So that we need to have to observe in the particular quantity of area what is the amount of water present, so that we need to remove the total water in the first level. After that we need to remove the mud, so that the process will be easiest to us. It is a numerical example for calculating a particular quantity of borehole data with respect to their heights. That means H1, H2, H3 they are giving with respect to meters. That means the length is in terms of meters. After that the borehole was bailed at a depth of 10.5 meters. Means 10 meters means simply a 33 feet, 33 and this point simply 35 feet distance he got a borehole with plenty of water below the ground surface, and the rise of water is recorded at 24 hours intervals as follows. At particular H1 he will record, and H2 he will record, and H3 he will record. Likely each height he has to wait for a 24 hour span, and he need to record the quantity of flow of water in a clay stream. HW equal to total height, that means HW equal to 10.5 feet, and delta t equal to time difference equal to 24 hours. So that he has to wait for a 24 hours period, and after the 24 hours is over he need to go for another length. That means 0.61, 0.57, 0.51 likely. So that HW equal to H1 square by H2 minus H1 minus H2. Likely he has to calculate H1, H2, H3. Likely simply those distances 6.615, 5.415 and 4.335 respectively. What is the height for first day? That means simply he has calculated 6.615, so that the total length is 10.5 meters. From the 10.5 meters he need to remove. In the second day HW2 equal to total height 10.5 minus this H1 plus H2 minus this, so that the 3 feet, so 3.885, 3.885 and 3.882, it will give the a successive depth of a groundwater level. Okay, you have a better understanding after observing this example. That means we are having all those terms HW, delta T, H1, H2, H3. What is the, you know, few students will not having a capacity to understand while we are telling with respect to words. Why? Because those words are not understand to everyone. If we give an example with respect to data, automatically they will have a clear understanding of the particular problem. This is the total problem, first day, second day, third day, how much amount of depth they need to dig down the particular ground surface. First day they digged amount of 3.88 meters, after second day also they digged amount of 3.88 meters, in third day they digged for a particular small quantity of height of 4.455. So that the total 4 plus 3 plus 3 simply 10. they more than 10.5 meters they driven the hole, so that average depth of the hole equal to total h1 plus h2 plus h3, those three are the heights for 3 days, day 1, day 2, day 3, so that average is equal to 4.075 meters. Next one, controlling measures for the groundwater level. What are the different control measures we have to use to control groundwater flow in our locality? Normally, if the structure is too small, there is no fear to us for this groundwater. If the structure is too large, automatically we have to know what is the depth we are having. That means the groundwater is having. Purpose. First of all, we have to know what is the purpose of choosing this control of groundwater. We are having the points 3. First of all, the purpose of control the surface of the subsurface or subsurface hydrologic environment in such a way to permit the structure to be constructed in the dry position. That means if it is a water, automatically there is no chance to construct a particular body. That means in a concrete is totally a solid substance. So that initially we are having a liquid form of concrete, that means with respect to water, so that we need to dry it for attaining a particular strength in foundation level. So that if it is a water, means automatically the water will obstruct to get that particular strength, so that we need to have a dry surface for the construction of any structure, so that we need to have this dry property. Whenever there is a ground, automatically we have to lay our construction as easy as possible. Normally in major projects in summer season and winter season, they are free for constructing a structure, but in case of the rainy season, it is not fair to the construction process. Why? Because a huge quantity of this water will flowing from the sky to this ground level, so that those will obstruct the constructing process and working process. And in some of the places also, there may be a damage to the materials. Those are used for the construction process, so that they will have to wait for a shiny day. In that particular shiny days, they will start their construction. Next one, dewatering means the separation of water from the soil, taking the water out from the particular construction problem completely. That means there is, if it is a water on a particular surface, we need to remove the total quantity of water from the soil or surface to for our construction purpose. Why? Because we are constructing a structure, it will be useful for a different purposes, whether it is an industrial structure or a residential structure or commercial structure, whatever it may be, we are simply doing a construction so that the land should be suitable for construction purpose, so that if it is the total land will not have a quantity of water lying on the particular surfaces. This leads to concepts like pre-drainage of soil and the control of groundwater and even the improvement of physical properties of soil. That means it leads to concepts. That means concepts like we are designing a concept like pre-drainage of soil. Pre-drainage means normally in our houses we are using these drainage holes and other different PVC pipes for simply flowing off or removing of water from our houses. Why? Because of you normally daily we are using different purposes like washing our clothes and washing these houses, and for our purpose also normally we are using a water quantity. That means for every day we have to use 135 liters per every person. That is a normal quantity of water required for each person as per standards, 135 liters. So that if it is a home, automatically per a day there is a small 4% automatically we have to consume simply 500 to 550 liters, so that all the water will not have to stay in our house. Why? Because the water will use a foul smell or any other bacteria into the house, so that we need to drainage those water from our house to the sub canals, small canals or side canals, so that it will lead to a pre-drainage program. Normally in our houses we are designing this pre-drainage. That means before the construction we are looking for these drainage properties in around our soils.
Likely, we have to go for this pre-drainage of soil before we construct a structure, and we need to locate these pre-drainage techniques available in our soil location. Next one, control of groundwater. That means we need to control the entrainment of this groundwater onto the structure. Why? Because the entrainment of groundwater means automatically the total soil in the field will absorb the groundwater and it will swelling, or in sometimes it will be shrinkage. So that due to the swellings and shrinkages, automatically there may be an I will draw with the particular diagram, which is the total quantity of land we are having. Due to these rain waters, automatically there may be a stagging of particular quantity of water. Due to this water, automatically the soil will swells due to this water. Particular, this is called as a swelling. This is due to falling of water. After the water percolation is over in particular summer seasons, the total water will be absorbed by this natural temperature, likely 40 degrees and 50 degrees. In our conditions, we are facing this 40 to 45 degrees temperature. Due to those temperature, the total water will be evaporated from the ground level, so that we have to face this shrinkage, especially in black cotton soils. We are observing there may be a huge quantity of cracks or forming due to this evaporation of water in particularly summer seasons. But in case of rainy seasons, there may be a problem of swelling. Swelling means increment of volume, shrinkage means decrement of volume. Those two things are forming the season to season. Why? Because of this availability of water. So that we need to avoid those kind of situations by simply restrictions we need to have onto our soils to allow water. During construction stage, what we have to follow? That means provide a dry excavation and permit construction to proceed efficiently. That means dry excavation. If there is a dry season, dry excavation means automatically we need to do our work as fast as possible. That means as fastly as possible. If it is a water, means automatically the total quantity of volume may be increases. It may be leads to some amount of disturbance to the working, so that we need to go for a dry excavation. It will be safer for equipments also. Why? Because if the equipment is working under water, means automatically there may be some amount of slippings and other damages to be takes place by entering this water to the particular mechanics. That means mechanical bodies, so that it will also leads to damage of the particular equipment. So that we need to give a dry excavation process for a structure. Next, we have this reduce lateral loads on the sheeting or bracing of excavation. That means lateral load means normally these lateral loads are normally we have to observe with respect to these wind loads. Lateral means on lateral direction with respect to a structure we have to face. Those loads are called as a normally lateral loads. Wind loads, due to this wind also some amount of structure have to face some amount of deformations. That means normally in our surroundings we have to observe these radio towers and cell phone towers, normally electrical towers, all those are having a huge height, so that in this particular height they are simply giving a particular quantity of gaps. That means the total structure is not built with these RCC members, simply they are constructing with these steel members. In those steel also they are not completely constructing. Why? Because if the structure is totally completely constructing, automatically there may be have to face these wind loads, so that they are simply using these bracings and like different things, so that in the bracings means automatically there may be some quantity of gap, so that the wind there may will not act on the structure. Simply the wind will be have to flow in between the gaps. I will show with the diagram. The total structure means here we are having these bracings, likely we are having different quantity of structures in our purposes. This is a total quantity of gap. In those gaps or total air will be flows, so that there may be a for that there may be no lateral force acting on a particular structure. After that, we are having this stabilizer quick bottom condition. That means stabilization means simply we have to do for lime and other stabilizer cement properties or lime or any other calcium properties we have to use. Next one, improve supporting characteristics of foundation materials. That means of foundation means normally we are going for RCC. Then that means reinforced cement concrete materials we are using for the purpose of foundation, so that it will give a better support characteristics. Next one, increase stability by excavation of slopes and side hills, comma fills. After the foundation is over, we have to give a better support to the foundation by filling those foundations with the help of these fine grained particles. That means normally nowadays we are using this stone dust as a filling materials. Why? Because stone dust having a small quantity of particle size. In some of the cases they are filling with these chips and others. Those chips are not suitable for the filling purpose. Why? Because the chips having some quantity of voids. But in case of the stone dust, the voids will be so less, so that it will be suitable for the filling purpose with respect to foundation. And they will increase the stability of the structures. Cut off capillary rise and pavement piping. That means prevent pipings and forced heavening pavements. That means cut off capillary rise. Capillary rise means automatically if there is a flow of water, the water table will be rises. So that we need to prevent those rising of water table by simply filling these huge density materials. So that there may be no voids means automatically there is no flow of groundwater. Next one, reduce air pressure in tunneling operations. And then we have to reduce the air pressure automatically. If there is air pressure means there may be a chance of burstings.